Hello, everybody, and welcome back. We are here beyond to infinity. Here we go. Look at the loot. Oh, this is so good. Look at all that coal. Look at all that redstone. Lapis. Not much lapis, though. Not much lapis. Little lacking in the lapis. Decent amount of diamonds, though. I will not be upset about that, as well as all the other resources here. Oh, now we are talking. Now, right at the... Stop it. Right at this exact second, we do have a bit of a concern. We are draining out our power pretty sufficiently. Mainly because our power's not amazing or anything. The setup's pretty good. Our tree oil does hold up for a while, but our resin does drop out after time, and eventually we do run out of power. So that is a bit of a concern, and I'd like to address that a little bit today. So many people online, over on Sprout especially. There was just four on Beyond before I started recording, and now we're down to just the two of us. Other people needed to do things, probably. But let's carry on. Let's venture forth and see. See, there we go. Sergio's back. See? We're all good. It's amazing the activity in the past few days on all the servers, and little to no issues for the most part, which is awesome. No real big concerns or anything like that. So very happy about all of that. We need to get some better power. We need better power. By the way, if you guys do want to join, all the subscriber info is down below. And the chat is just going bonkers. I might have to turn it off during the video here. A couple things. Obviously, our jetpack is still pretty basic. We can do a lot of things still there. We need to set up some sort of an auto-processing, auto-storage system for our entire setup, including the quarry here. I do have Silk Touch in there. I can't remember if I showed you guys that last episode or not. We have the Enchanted Book with Silk Touch. But we still, there's a few things that we need to void out. There's a few things that we need to process. Before all that, I want to get my power situated so that we're actually, you know, keeping this thing nice and powered up. I don't want to run out. Simple as that, right? Because if we run out in the quarry, it means we're going to run out in our power systems to auto-process all of that, etc., etc. So let's work on it. We got the digital guide from Environmental Tech. Indeed. Environmental Tech is a pretty sweet mod that offers lots of cool things, including some world gen, different ways of getting power, like a lightning rod or a solar array. It does add an item like a laser drill from Mine Factory Reloaded. For those of you that are familiar with the old mods, basically it's a miner that generates ore, similar to what we have in the quarry that we built last episode, that guy right there. It's a little bit slower, though. It's not as quick as the quantum quarry, in my opinion, until you get to a higher level. Like, you get to a tier 4, you're talking pretty good mining. There's a few other things. There's like nanobots and stuff. I've never dealt with those. And there's witherproof blocks as well, which is kind of cool. All right. World gen, alabaster, hardened stone, and basalt. Okay. So quick note on this. We are going to make a solar array. They are very powerful. They are very expensive. So I do recommend having a decent amount of resources ready to go. Now, a solar array tier 1 is 648 RF per tick. Okay. Solar array tier 2 is 3600 RF per tick. Now, this is kind of where it gets a little interesting. I think we need to go straight to a tier 2. I don't know if I'm going to have all the resources for it. So a tier 2 requires structure block tier 2 or above times 24 with 25 solar cells. Okay, so 24, if I remember correctly, 24 structure blocks tier 2 and 25 solar cells. So let's take a look at that. Let's take a look at the solar cells first. If I could type, that would be helpful. These guys right here. We need 25 of these. And that's going to require a lot of lapis lazuli. That might be the hiccup. I do not think that I have that much lapis. I don't think we got that much lapis. Just saying. Because we only have four here. And yeah, this might be 133. Ooh, boy. Yeah, I don't think that this is going to be something that we can do. We could maybe get a tier one. Huh. That kind of throws it a little bit for a loop. I did want to point out to you all, though, that if you take your chisel and you get this regular basalt from chisel, what you can do is you can throw that in there and you can get the environmental tech basalt. Okay, so that's one of the easy ways to get the environmental tech version of basalt. We have that. We need more nether stars too. Oh man. We got the quarry though. I want to focus on the quarry here first. Withers are easy, right? I mean, we could have gone draconic evolution. We could have gone a lot of different things. But I think right now we need to fix our power situation. You know what? Let's build a tier one. Let's build a tier one to start with, because that can eventually evolve, as far as I know, into a tier two. So maybe I'll make the 9 solar cells with the... Yeah, we'll do the 9 solar cells right now. Let's do those. You know what else I might not have enough of? We might not have enough nether quartz. Most definitely do not. Okay. I'm pretty sure we don't. Nether quartz. Do I not have any more? Man, we've gone through that so quick. Okay. Alright. You know what? Side train. We'll do the solar panel next time. We'll do it next time. It's fine. We'll do it next time. You know? It's one of those things. I wasn't prepared for it, I guess. So instead, I've come up with another solution just off the top of my head. Boom. Extreme reactors. We have a whole bunch of yellowite ore right here. It's coming in from the quarry, and we seem to be getting a decent amount of it. So let's start going and working on an extreme reactor. I believe I still have some more even right here. So let's do this up. Let's get this processed. What is the best method? Obviously cooking it, I think pulverizer. Ooh, tectonic pulverizer gives 3. That is spicy. That gives 3 too with blazing pyrothium. I think just regular pulverizer is the key. So we'll go regular pulverizer. What does the sag mill do? It gives a cyanite. It's fine. And then the yellorium dust we can smelt into yellorium. Okay, good. What? Hey! Wait, slain by grizzly. One more hit. Oh no. Must have got the grizzly bear. Bears are vicious in that pack, man. Holy cow, they are brutal. They will mess you up. Alright. Okay, so we're going to get some yellorium. I did make a little bit of graphite bars as well. And let's look into some extreme reactors. It kind of actually suits this a little bit better for where we are at the moment. A bit of lag on the sprout, maybe? That's not good. Maybe some people are exploring, trying to find their base. That could definitely be a concern. Okay. So let's get down to business here. Obviously, we're going to need a reactor controller. That's going to require some of that yellorium, but we're also going to need a whole bunch of these reactor casings, which is going to require a lot of graphite bars. Okay. Now, if I remember correctly, I'm pretty sure coal or charcoal in a furnace. Is that basically it? Is that the only thing that we can do this with? Graphite? Dust? Yeah, I think so. So, coal in that thing. Okay. Well, we have lots of coal. We have tons of coal. that we can just start processing up here to get this done through the pulverizing, right? So this should pulverize out, and we should start melting up some coal. Good. So that's going to give us the yellowrium and start producing us the graphite bars as well. And it should give us some pulverized coal, which is nice. Okay. All right, so we'll get some of this. I don't know how much we need. We need a lot of graphite. I'm going to put together a few resources, because obviously I was planning solar to begin with, but I'm going to put together a few things here on our end. We'll put those in there, and let's go at extreme reactor. There we go. So we're going to need a lot of reactor casing, which means we're going to need a few of these reactor casing cores. You get four per, but this is probably the best area to start out with. 14, probably not quite enough for sure. And then we're going to need a lot more graphite on top of that for everything else. So we got a few resources and a few processes that we need to get in place here. All right, so I think I've come up with a pretty straightforward design that's not too encumbersome, if you know what I mean. I do have a few of these casings made up, probably not enough. Yeah, no, not enough. That's all right. Let's get a few more done up here and just store it away. We should have the resources. I think I need like 140 of these things, though. Like, we might need a little over two stacks total, so I might need a few more than I first thought up. Let's get a decent amount. It's not a huge system by any means, but it is still, I mean, there's a lot of infrastructure. Oh, man, that's silly. There is a lot of infrastructure that is required on this setup, and we're basically out of that again. Okay, so reactor controller, we should be able to get one of those. Good. What else do we need? We need a access port, right? Okay, we need a chest for that. Boom, chest, boom. Nope. No chests. No chests. They're all right down here, aren't they? There we go. Nailed it. We can convert those back over. Good. All right. Reactor. Let's go. Access port. Coolant port. I'm pretty sure they're the exact same thing. So, yeah. We just need the access port. And now we need a piston. Which means we need more wood. Archaic system that I have here. Okay. Good and good. Let's get this done. Boom. Piston. Boom. Good. Put that away. Get that. Okay. Awesome. So we got the two access ports. That's good. We're going to need, I think it's five control rods. Five of these. I'll just do it shift click wise. Oh, what are we missing? Oh, we're short graphite now. Okay. We need more graphite. That's fine. That's perfectly fine. We got lots of coal. There's a lot of little things moving on with this guy. And I did make up a little bit more iron while we were at it. So let's put these all in here. And you know what? While we're waiting for that graphite, we can actually start to build this thing. Now, most of my main power is over here. So I'm thinking we should tap in right back here with the reactor. Okay, and I'm pretty sure my reactor, if I'm not mistaken, I could very well be, was a 5x5. Whoa, what the heck happened there? That was an interesting bit of stuff. Okay, interesting. How much? Oh, God, there's so many bad blocks in this, isn't there? Yeah, there's a lot of bad blocks. Okay, I might have to relock. There's a lot of bad blocks in there. Okay. Yeah. Got all those. Oh, God. Okay. I got to be right back, I guess. We got to relog. We derped. The server derped. I think, like I said, I told a lot of people that we've had 5 or 10 new subscribers in the last 2 days. So I think that what really happened is people are generating chunks till they find their base, right? Till they find their home. And that's what's kind of happening on the server at the moment with a little bit of block leg, right? I mean, chunks generated even in vanilla Minecraft on a server is a bit of a burden on the servers. And you know, I've actually talked, I think going forward we should probably look to pre-generate a set number of chunks in the worlds before we get too carried away or have too many people logging in, right? So that's something that we'll probably implement on our end a little bit just to improve the overall systems, right? Okay, how big did I make this thing? 5x5x2? What? Oh yeah, that's internal. Yeah, 5x5x2 I think is what I did. So let's see. If we were to tap in somewhere here, I'm thinking we're going to move the power capacitors right over to here. Kind of keep it nice and tight. So we'll go boom, that's 3, that's 5, right? So that's 5 right there, and then 5 and 5, right? So that's a 5x5, is that correct? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 5, perfect, okay. Now, it's a matter of, do I sink this into the ground a little bit more? I'm thinking yes. I'm thinking let's go 2 down, and let's sink this into the floor. That way it's just not really in our way. It's not sticking out or anything like that. So I'm thinking we come down here. Let's get our wand out, because that's going to help immensely with this build. We'll go all reactor. It's fine, everybody. Perfectly fine. I meant to do that. I totally meant to do that. Okay. Boom, boom. Okay, so we got the reactors all the way along the bottom. Good. Now, because it's too high internal, I think that is 4 high external. Is that correct? I'm pretty sure that is the case. So we can do that. And then we can just do this quickly. Boop. I don't really care about glass or anything like that around the outside. You know, it's not really important to us. This isn't big enough. It's one more out. Two more out. In each direction. So it's a 7x7 external. Yeah, that's right. Okay. 7x7 external with a 5x5 internal. That's the magic number. Okay, there we go. Boom, 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 boom. Good, and then we're too high internal. That's correct. And this needs to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, we need to move this back. It's fine. You can't, it doesn't break it in a 3x3 for these casings. So keep that in mind. So let's see, if we need this to be our external wall right here, where do we need to go with this? So that goes up like that, that goes up like that, good. So now we need to make a 5x5 in here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we have 5 going that way. So we need to go 2 blocks more out this way. Right? I think my math is sound now. Maybe, maybe not, probably not. Okay, boom, boom. Boom. Okay, good. Now we should be able to do that. And that. Okay, built it all. Excellent. And this should be across like so. And we should now have our 5x5 internal. Sweet. Obviously, we need a few more reactor casings and stuff. But let's just quickly go through here. And I want to set up our reactor controller, as well as our input and output, right? So this will be our input right there. Yeah, that's good. And this will probably be our output right there. So we'll do our 2 access ports right beside it. That one will be import. This will be our export, right, on outlet mode. And then because I want my power capacitor to be basically right here, I guess we'll do that right there. Right? I think that that should make sense, which we haven't made yet. We haven't made that yet. So we'll get that. We'll get that done. Let's get our graphite. It should pretty much all be done at this point. Oh, baby. Look at all that goodness. Look at all that goodness. We'll get up a few more, too. We'll get up a few more while we're at it. All right. Let's go. Put that all away. This stuff here we'll have to store somewhere else, but that's fine. Okay. So we should have all of that. We need some of these. We need 5 total. This is kind of one of the expensive parts, all things considered. We need more reactor casing. There we go. Good. Good. 32 more. Hopefully that's enough. Hopefully that's enough. So we need one more of these. Good. And then we do need to get the Yellorium fuel rods. Oh, of course it's not gonna. Okay, fuel rods. I said fuel rods. Fuel rods. Okay. These guys right here. Reactor fuel rod. Of course. Why would they name it Yellorium? Now, I think we need 10 of these. I'm pretty sure that's the case. Let's get the 10. Nice. Perfect. Okay. Is that it? Oh, no, we need the power tap. We need the reactor power tap as well. We never made that, did we? This guy right here. Very cheap item. Not expensive in the slightest. Okay, so we have our power tap. That's going to go down right there. We can complete the rest of this as well. Like that. Excellent. Now we can start putting in our stuff. So we can put in our fuel rods, like so. Good. On top of that, of course, is going to be our control rods. It's all pretty much the same as what Big Reactors was prior. So most of what you're doing here is familiar. Or it uh-oh. Don't mind me. It's fine. It's fine, everybody. No. All planned. All right, there we go. Let's get all this loot. I'm going to go pretty simple, very simple with this. I don't want to make a ton of power. That's not my goal here. I think we're just going to do some blocks of gold through this. Because we do have a decent amount of gold, I think that's all I'm going to do with this setup. And because somebody generously donated me a whole bunch of gold, I'm not even sure how much we need. Let's just take out, we'll just take out the stack, and we'll leave all the rest in there. Yeah, kind of nice having subs with all the benefits of playing a lot more than I can. We only need a few. We don't need very many. I guess it's only 8, isn't it? I mean, I guess we could. This is kind of optional. You could go along the outside here, too. It will net you more power. So I guess that's cool. We'll do that. Because we have so much access to gold, you could also use graphite out here if you wanted to as well. But it's definitely not required in the slightest. And then we're just going to throw the cap on top so that we don't ruin everything. I'm a few short, I think. Yeah, just a couple short. All right, let's do that up quickly. You know what? No, we'll do one right there. Perfect. Okay. All right. You must go. Bye. Bye, Sam. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. Bye-bye. Bye-bye now. All right. Let's get a few more of these. Let's get a few more. It's fine. You know, all things considered, Big Reactors, or Extreme Reactors in this case, was never an expensive mod. Depending on how much infrastructure and everything you wanted to actually set up was more or less the bigger problem. Now this guy right here should give us a good amount of RF, quite a good amount, over 4,000, I believe. So let's quickly grab some of this Yellorium that we've processed up. We don't have too much, so I don't want to go bonkers with it, but we can throw that in there, and as you can see, it filled up the fuel rods already. I am going to fire this guy up, but we also need to get adequate cabling, right? Because our cabling, these guys here can handle, 5,000. Oh, that might be enough. That might be enough. Let's get a few more of these made up. Boom. That might just be enough. I'm going to quickly remove this. Yeah, we'll remove all this. Uh-oh. There, we're fine. We're fine. We're fine, everybody. And we're going to break everything. Everything's broken. Everything's broken. Breaking all the things. All right, we're going to submerge this down one level just to get nice and cushy. There we go. Very good. That will be disabled. We don't want that on there. And this guy will connect like that. So now we can set up the input out the backside there. And the output can still remain on this side, and we can fuel it into everything else. Understandably so. Okay, so this can only take 3,000 RF per tick input. Let's see what this thing does for us. I'm pretty sure it does more than that. What are we looking at for top here? It should be pretty efficient, all things considered. We're looking at about 5.6 maybe? 4.6, sorry, KRF per tick. That's pretty good. Pretty low heat, nothing too crazy there. And pretty decent amount of yellorium usage or storage. Not much at all. I feel that this is pretty efficient. I'm sure other people have more efficient designs. I probably should have put like gelid cryothium and gone crazy with this. But I think for a nice, simple, early game reactor, the amount of resources that we use, or sorry, mid-game reactor, I feel are pretty good. Now we're getting 4.55. That seems about right. Okay, so we're getting about 4,500 RF per tick. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. All things considered, that's very good. So we need to accommodate or adjust all of our stuff to work accordingly. So we obviously need to upgrade our capacitors. These are all basics. I'd like to do some upgrades. Oh yeah, we got to fix all the power. We need more power, everybody. We need to fix the power. This is very important. So we can come across here like this, and then we can pipe in there instead. So now the quarry is getting power directly from that box, and then we can pipe in here accordingly. Okay, so that should be providing, that will be providing power here shortly. These guys, we're going to move all of these. It's time to move. It's time to reorganize some of our power systems. So that'll just come up and over just to get power back to all of that as well. Okay. All right, so we have power again. So I do want to get some capacitors going, and then we can another basic or two of these. So we need a few of the basic capacitors. I think we're going to do 8. Oh, perfect amount of gold. Perfect amount of gold. Do we just have this? We don't have it. We don't have it. Block of redstone. 1, 2. Sure, that's fine. Boom. 1 and 2. Okay. So 2 more basic capacitors. This should at least raise us to 5,000. RF input and output. So as you can see, we are inputting, we are outputting. We should be actually pulling down the buffer now, even though it did fill up there. We've gone through a couple yellorium so far. So the next step here is to definitely get this yellorite ore auto-processed and ready to go for the rest of this system, right? I'm just going to boop, 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 boop. Boop, 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 boop. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's just get rid of all this. Don't need any of that dirt. Don't need the dirt. Don't need the canola either. Or the seeds. Yeah. Don't click this too quick or else it's like, we can't do that. All right. Boop, boop, boop. All right. Much better. Okay, so we are getting input. We are getting about 4.5. Very happy with that. That's a lot more power than what we had over here. We were only dealing with, 300 times 4, right? So that's only 1,200 here. And we just, quadrupled it, basically. So we're very good. We're in good condition. We're in good standing going forward, I think, on power. Next step is to probably automate some of this stuff and get things moving in an according in a good fashion. So I think that's going to be it for today, though. Yeah, I think that's it for today. But stay tuned, because next episode, we got some auto processing to set up and more storage stuff to deal with. Indeed. All right, everybody. Bye-bye for now. Leave a like, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Appreciate it, and have a good one.